Hey, what is up guys? Welcome back to another City Skylines video on the channel, and today we are going to look at some ways you can load and run City Skylines on your computer much faster than you could before with a high FPS. To do this, we're going to change settings, download a little thing called Razer Cortex, and install some mods, proving everything along the way with this frame tracker we have working right here through Steam. Everything is free and easy, so if you want to play City Skylines on that potato PC with a lot of frames per second, stick around for the rest of this video. Okay, just as a baseline, the computer I'm running City Skylines on has the bare minimum specs to play the game on. It took around 10 minutes to load a game, and we're averaging around 6 frames per second on an empty map, which isn't very playable. So first things first, you're going to need to get into your City Skylines settings and disable all of the quality settings down at the bottom or set them to low. Then you want to make sure that there's no color correction override, no film grain, and that depth of field is disabled. After that, you're going to want to set the resolution to something a lot lower than 1080p, but something that is at least visible. For me right now, that's going to be 1024 by 768. Or 800 by 600 pixels if you also reduce the aspect ratio to 4x3 instead of the standard 16x9, which I definitely recommend. You don't have to switch the aspect ratio if you don't want to, and if you want to play the game at full screen, but if you're looking for the most frames possible, that's what you're going to have to do. After those changes in the settings, the game loads a lot quicker, and is definitely playable with an average frames per second being 21. It does make the game's graphics look like SimCity 4, so how smooth you want to play the game kind of depends on how pixelated you want to see your city. But that's not all. Moving on to tip number 2, we have an application you can download called Razer Cortex that will boost the frame rate in any game, but in this case, City Skylines. Razer Cortex is a free Windows application that can help improve performance in games, particularly if you're running titles that demand large amounts of RAM, like City Skylines. Razer Cortex can also help you recover 1 or 2 GB of memory from background processes, which can be enough to eradicate frame drops or lag caused by disk reads. If you're on Mac, just download Memory Free. It's pretty much just an Apple OS alternative. All you have to do is hit the download button on the Razer website, link will be in the description below, and the zip file will be downloaded to your computer. Just follow a quick installation step and you'll find this Razer icon in the hidden icons tab towards the bottom right of your computer, as well as a desktop app. Once in either of those, Razer Cortex will automatically recognize the games on your computer and show it to you so that you can click on it to open the game with the boosted Razer features. As you see here, it's clearing up memory to be dedicated towards City Skylines. After I had Razer Cortex installed, my average frames per second boosted to 26+. It's not a ton, but it's noticeable and will reduce any given frame drops or lag. Last up on the list, we have a couple of City Skylines mods for you to subscribe to on the Steam Workshop that are definitely going to increase your performance. The mods include Dynamic Resolution, FPS Booster, Ultimate Mod 2.9, Loading Screen Mod, and the Less Steam Mod. After you subscribe to all of those, you're going to want to open up the City Skylines main menu and click on Content Manager, where you will then click on the Mods tab, which is going to bring you to a screen displaying all of your mods. Now, click the On button for all of the mods you just subscribed to so that the mods are up and running. You may have to restart the game after doing so, but a video describing some of the mods and how to use them will be in the description below. Other than that, you can jump right into your game and they'll work on their own. Finally, City Skylines is playing at a solid 38+ frames per second for me, and the map only took around 1 minute and 4 seconds to load. Results may vary, but if you do everything in this video, your City Skylines performance will increase tremendously. Let me know how much faster your game got down below, as well as some tips and tricks you found out while trying to make City Skylines run smoother. Anyways, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next City Skylines video.